Steve Patterson here again from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I'll show you the easy way to crop a single layer in Photoshop. So one of the main complaints about Photoshop is that things that should be simple are not. And maybe the best example of that is when trying to crop a single layer. Now, I covered the pro way to crop a layer in a separate video that I've linked to in the description. But a lot of people have said that it should be easier and that you should be able to crop a layer using just the crop tool. Unfortunately, the crop tool won't work, and here's why. If we look in my layers panel here, we see that I have two images, each on a separate layer. Right now, we're seeing the image on the top layer. But if I turn that layer off, we see the image below it. I'll turn the top layer back on. So I want to crop the image on the top layer around the two people. But I don't want to crop the entire document. I just want to hide everything outside the crop to reveal that second image behind it. But if I grab the crop tool from the toolbar and I drag out a cropping border around those people, and then I click Done in the taskbar, well, that doesn't work. Photoshop crops both layers together. And that's what always happens when we use the crop tool. It always crops the entire document. So I'll undo that by going up to the Edit menu and choosing Undo Crop. So the crop tool won't work. But there is another tool directly below the crop tool in the toolbar called the Frame tool. And that's the tool we need. Now, the main purpose of the frame tool is to place an image into a shape, but we can also use it to crop a single layer, and it's super fast and easy to do. So with the frame tool selected, go up to the options bar and choose a shape for the frame. As of Photoshop 2025, you can choose a rectangle shape, an elliptical shape, a triangle shape, or any of Photoshop's custom shapes. But in most cases, when you're cropping something, you'll want the rectangle shape. So I'll choose that one. Now, I do need to point out that there is a drawback to using the frame tool. I'll show you what that is and how to get around it in a moment. But to crop the layer with the frame tool, all you need to do is drag out a border around the area you want to keep, just like you would with the crop tool. Then release your mouse button, and the layer is cropped. It's that simple. Now, if we look in the Layers panel, notice that our image layer is now a frame layer, and it has two thumbnails. The thumbnail on the left is for the frame that the image is inside of, and the thumbnail on the right is for the content of the frame, which is our image. Now, it's important that you have the correct thumbnail selected, because you'll get different options depending on which thumbnail you choose. So right now, the frame thumbnail is selected, which we can tell by that white border around it. And with the frame selected, we get transform handles around the frame that we can drag to resize it. If you select the content thumbnail on the right, then you can drag inside the frame to move the image. If you want to resize the image inside the frame, make sure the content thumbnail is selected, and then click the Transform button in the taskbar. This displays the transform box and handles around the entire image, not just the area inside the frame. So you can drag the handles to resize it. And if you want to resize the image proportionally, make sure the link icon between the width and height fields in the options bar is selected before dragging the handles. I'll just drag the top handle down. You can also drag inside the box to reposition the image. And then click Done in the taskbar to accept it. Now, what if you want to move the frame and the image together? Just hold the Shift key on your keyboard and click on whichever thumbnail is not selected to select them both. Or you can select them both by clicking on an empty gray area of the layer. And now you'll see this solid blue border around the frame. And you can drag both the frame and the image together. If you want to hide all of those outlines, just select a different layer in the Layers panel. And that's how easy it is to crop a layer using the Frame tool. But as I mentioned, there is a drawback to using the Frame tool, which is that we can't apply any layer effects to the frame. Now, you can add a stroke around the frame. Just make sure the frame thumbnail is selected, and then in the taskbar, you'll see options for choosing a stroke color and the stroke size. And you can choose to set the stroke to the inside of the frame, or the center, or the outside. But that is it. That's all you can do with the frame. You can add a stroke. So I'll hide the stroke by choosing the no color option. Watch what happens if I try to apply a layer effect. I'll make sure I have the frame selected, and then I'll click the layer effects icon at the bottom, and I'll choose drop shadow. But notice that no matter what I do here, we're not seeing the shadow behind the frame. And that's because the effect is actually being applied to the image inside the frame. If I select the content and I drag the image so we can see the edge, and I just give it a second to update, well, there is our drop shadow around the image. So the effect is applied to the image, not to the frame, which is why we can't see it. I'll undo that by pressing Ctrl-Z or Command-Z on a Mac, and I'll delete my drop shadow by dragging it onto the trash bin. The trick to getting around this problem is to place the frame layer into a group, and then apply your layer effects to the group. So with the frame layer selected, you can either go up to the Layer menu and choose Group Layers, even though we have just that one layer selected, or you can press Ctrl-G or Command-G on a Mac. And back in the Layers panel, we see that our frame layer is now inside a group. So with the group itself selected, if I click again on the Layer Effects icon and I choose Drop Shadow, now we can see the shadow behind the image. And there we have it. That's how to crop a single layer using the Frame tool in Photoshop. I hope this video was helpful, and if it was, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to the channel for more Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.